All right, now Bengaluru is all set to host the biggest show of unity. The swearing-in ceremony of Kumaraswamy today will witness a massive gathering of non-BJP chief ministers from across the country. UPA Chairperson Sonia Gandhi and Congress President Rahul Gandhi will attend the ceremony. This even as Telangana Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao has decided to skip the event. But KCR flew down to Bengaluru to meet HD Devegowda and Kumaraswamy yesterday. Some of the VVIP invitees include Tejaswi Yadav from Bihar, West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, who have already reached Bengaluru. In fact, there are others like Mayawati, Akhilesh Yadav, Arvind Kejriwal, those who are also making their way to Bengaluru. Chandrababu Naidu is also expected to be part of this swearing-in ceremony. However, BJP has boycotted the swearing-in ceremony, calling for a statewide protest against what they call unholy alliance. Sources have told India Today that Yediyurappa will stage a massive protest at Gandhi statue in Bengaluru at the Vidhan Sabha today. Congress JDS combined have invited opposition heavyweights, which include Mayawati, Akhilesh Yadav, Chandrababu Naidu, Stalin, Arvind Kejriwal, Kamala Hassan and Pinarayi Vijayan from Kerala as well.
We are not talking about Modi as a person. We are talking about what he represents in terms of a divisive idea, in terms of somebody whose ideas have done greatest damage to democracy and the democratic institution, constitutional morality, constitutional propriety. That is why even those parties which had minor differences, they are coming together because the greater cause is that the nation has to be protected in 2019.
The high-voltage drama in Karnataka might have ended for the time being, but what transpired in Karnataka has left many questions unanswered. The most prominent is the opposition planning to unite against the Prime Minister, and if so, can it hold the Modi juggernaut for the 2019 polls?
Laughter, celebration. In a big build-up ahead of the 2019 elections, Karnataka turned out to be a massive disappointment for the BJP. Despite being the single largest party, Amit Shah's Chanakya Niti did not work this time. The Modi juggernaut was halted after Congress gave unconditional support to arch-rivals JDS. Will the Karnataka model be the opposition template for 2019 to halt the Modi wave?
2019 में एकदम जिस तरीके से विपक्ष जो गोलबंद हो रहा है और एक साथ दिखाई दे रहा है अगर इसी तरीके से हम लोग चलते रहें तो मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि जो 2019 का जो चुनाव है बीजेपी मुक्त हो जाएगा केंद्र
बीजेपी के खिलाफ माहौल बनता चला जा रहा है और कर्नाटक के चुनाव से और कर्नाटक के इस सदन में जो नहीं सरकार बना पाए क्योंकि कीमतें तय हो रही थी विधायकों की कि 100-100 करोड़ में विधायक खरीदे जा रहे हैं ये भारतीय जनता पार्टी की नई संस्कृति है
With almost all opposition heavyweights invited for Kumaraswamy's swearing-in on Wednesday, is Congress along with other opposition parties laying a roadmap for 2019? To defeat the mighty Modi-Shah duo, opposition parties have to stitch a pre-poll alliance. Just like Karnataka, they have to overcome their differences and form an anti-Modi front. Not only this, they have to capitalize on the anti-incumbency against Modi Sarkar. The BJP sweep in states like Assam, Tripura and resurgence in Karnataka speaks volumes about Prime Minister Narendra Modi's unwavering popularity. The opposition has its task cut out. To beat back the BJP in upcoming polls in Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Mizoram.
It was BJP's Waterloo moment, having failed in what many say is the semi-final before the final in 2019. The BJP was given a taste of its own medicine by a more sharper and dexterous opponent. With video journalist Kripal Singh, this is Mausmi Singh in Bengaluru for India Today.
Well, throughout the campaign, Kumaraswamy had insisted that he will be the king, not the kingmaker. And now it has come true. So here's a glimpse at Kumaraswamy, the new chief minister of Karnataka and his political career.
People of Karnataka, they are not telling that I will going to become a kingmaker. Most of the citizens of Karnataka and the voters, they wanted to bless me as a king. to rule this state for future 5 years.
The richest chief ministerial candidate in the 2018 Karnataka elections, Kumaraswamy, won from both the Ramnagara and the Channapatna seat. Kumaraswamy could be also credited of the JDS's better showing in these elections. Kumaraswamy, son of former Prime Minister H.D. Devagoda, first became a Member of Parliament in 1996 from Kanakapura district when his father was still the Prime Minister. He had a brief stint as the Karnataka Chief Minister from 2006 to 2007, but he was forced to step down from the post over souring relationships with the coalition partner BJP. Back then, the Congress had refused to lend support to the JDS and had even demanded President's rule in Karnataka.
They want the person who is going to protect their interest. Safeguard their interest. That person they are searching. In me, they have searched me that he will going to save our interest.
The 58-year-old Vokaliga leader's elevation to the chief minister's post lay bare the Congress's extreme desperation to return some sort of say in the state's functioning. As they say, when it comes to politics, there are no permanent friends or foes. Bureau Report, India Today.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.